my opinions to the meeting. It's a bit challenging for me also, this, because this meeting is a little bit unusual, both in terms of the speeches delivered and the evaluators. You don't normally get, if you notice, most of the speakers, the benefit of the guests and newer Toastmasters, most of the speakers were experienced speakers doing advanced speeches. Even Nancy, even though she's attempting the icebreaker, it's a repeat after 10 years. So she said, well, that's why they all held to a higher standard. For the first timers, don't worry, we're not normally so harsh of the evaluations. After you finish your CC, you are normally evaluated more strictly. Not to say more harshly, but we expect more from you because you've already gotten the basics. So that's why most of the evaluators are a little bit more critical in terms of the expectations were higher, because you're already expected to be able to deliver much more. And it's an interesting thing because you rarely get all the evaluators being a distinguished Toastmasters. And DTM does not necessarily mean you're better. It means that you have achieved a certain level of commitment. And what I like is one of the international presidents said, DTM means dedicated to mentoring. Instead of distinguished Toastmasters, you're here to help people. So all of them are sharing their opinions. And there's a variety of opinions. Some of them were succinct, some of them were stricter, but all of them were trying to help the speakers to improve. So I like that thing. And by the way, on a side note, I think I've somehow or other, I've visited almost all the evaluators in their home clubs, I think. Just to let you know, this is my home club, Piyu Taman Home Club. People think I have my home club, a lot of other places, this is my one and only home club. Thank you. Right, ladies and gentlemen. The other part, what can I say? The evaluations, if I may also make comment, because these are very seasoned evaluators, very experienced people. I want to make a comment about this. If you notice, some of the evaluators standing behind the lectern, and some were standing in front. There is no right and wrong position. I don't want to get the newer Toastmasters to get that you are supposed to come out and stand. You can stand behind the lectern. If you feel more comfortable, you can stand in front. As long as you remember that the purpose of an evaluation is to shine a spotlight on the speaker. That's your job. Your job as an evaluator is to put the speaker on a pedestal, praise him or her where the praise is warranted, and put up suggestions for his or her consideration. How you do it, where you stand, that's up to you. Johnson, Mayappa, all of them are very good. Victor, very confident, they stand in front without notes, that's fine. You do not have to feel stressed. The newer Toastmasters do not have to do that. If you feel comfortable standing behind the lectern with the notes, so be it. Because your job is to make the speaker a better speaker than he or she is. So that's all it is. But if you feel you are comfortable up there, the chronic audience, by all means do so. So just wanted to point that out. I don't want people to get the wrong idea and say, oh, ultimately I must stand in front and read the notes. Not necessarily as an evaluator. Yes? The other part, I want to comment Johnson. I think he did a very nicely crafted his presentation very neatly. I did not realize that he was going to honor each of the invited evaluators personally, which is why I said, oh, the ASA, you must introduce Victor, you must introduce something, my apologies to you all. It's nicely done, but it's something away from the norm. But I thought it was very nicely done because it honored the evaluators because they have a long history of service to Toastmasters, and I thought it was very nicely done. Congratulations, George. Let's give him a round of applause. Also, I would like to honor our timekeeper, Mei Hong. She came all the way from OUM and gave took time for us. Thank you so much, Mei. Let's give her a her club as well. We should honor all those people who have helped us in one way or the other. All in all, it's a very nice meeting. I enjoyed it. I hope all of you enjoyed it thoroughly as well as much as I did. I have no major comments other than this. Thank you so much. It's been a wonderful meeting, and back to you, Mr. Toastmasters.